Good morning, students. In this today's class, we are going to discuss the atomic size, that is general properties of an d block element. Properties of d block elements. That is, we are taking the 3D series. The properties of an 3D series are d block elements. In that, first one, atomic size. Atomic size or ionic size. Atomic size or ionic size. Okay. In the last class, we have discussed the general introduction and the electronic configuration for the d block element. That is, mainly we have discussed the 3D series elements. Okay. In this class, we are going to discuss and properties of d block elements. In that, first one, atomic size or ionic size. Generally, the atomic size, generally from the atomic size from left to right in the periods, the atomic size will be the atomic size will be decreases and down the group, that is down the group, the atomic size will be increases. Atomic size will be increases because from left to right the number of orbit will be remain same and the charge will be increases. Therefore, that charge is the nuclear charge. Therefore, the atomic size will be decreases. From down the group, the number of orbit increases or the number of, that is, atomic number goes on increasing. Therefore, the atomic size will be down the group increases. In the d block element, that is 3D series, the elements are scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, copper, that is iron, nickel, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper and zinc. That is 21 to 30. Atomic number from 21 to 30 are known as 3D series elements. When we take the scandium, the number of orbits, when we take the electronic configuration of an scandium, that is 3D1 4S2. The electronic configuration for the titanium is 3D2 4S2. For the vanadium, 3D3 4S2. For the chromium, that is, it is an exception case, 3D5 4S1. For the manganese, 3D5 4S2, 3D6 4S2, here 3D7 4S2, 3D8 4S2, and here 3D10 4S2, and here 3D10 4S1, 3D10 4S2. This is the general, that is outermost electronic configuration for the d block, that is the 3D series elements. When we observe the 3D series elements, the number of orbit will be remain same, that is, these two are the exception case in the electronic configuration. 3D5 4S1 for the chromium, 3D10 4S1 for the copper. When we take the scandium, the nucleus 21 number of an protons are present, and the outermost orbit are the number of orbits are, then 3 plus 1, 4 orbits are present, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. For the vanadium, its atomic number is the, for the atomic 21, 23 is the atomic number for vanadium, and the number of orbits are 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And for the iron, that is, atomic number is 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. For the iron, that is, number of orbits are, that is, 26 is the atomic number, therefore the number of protons in the nucleus is 26, and the number of orbits are 4 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and when we take the zinc, the atomic number is 30, therefore number of protons in the nucleus is 14, and number of orbits are 4. When you observe in the 3D series elements, left to right, the number of orbits remains same. Here 4 orbits, 4, 4, 4, the number of orbits are same. Therefore, that is number of orbits are same here. And due to the same number of orbit, increase in the atomic number, the nuclear charge will be increases. Nuclear charge is the nuclear charge and screening effect. The nuclear charge will increase, decreases the atomic size. Nuclear charge will decrease the atomic size, whereas screening effect will be increase in the atomic size. The nuclear charge will decrease the atomic size, and the screening effect will increase in the atomic size. Then what is nuclear charge? The force of attraction between the nucleus and outermost orbit is known as anti-nuclear charge. The force of attraction between the nucleus and outermost orbit is known as anti-nuclear charge. Screening effect means the repulsion between the outermost and innermost orbit is known as anti-screening effect. This screening effect is also known as shielding effect. Shielding effect, screening effect, or shielding effect. That is, when we take the 3D series element, that is, the number of orbit remains same and the number of protons will be increases in the nucleus. Therefore, the nuclear charge will be increases, and the generally, left to right, the number of orbit remains same. Therefore, the nucleus, the left to right, the number of orbit remains same, and the number of proton will go on increasing. Therefore, the force of attraction between the nucleus and outermost orbit will be increases. That is screening, that is nuclear charge. The nuclear charge will be increases. Therefore, the atomic size will be decreases. Then due to the nuclear charge, the left to right atomic size will be increases. And shielding effect will be, when we take the down the group and 3D here, 3D series, 4D series, 5D series, and 6D series. When we compare, and number of orbit in the 3D series is 4, in the 4D series the number of orbit will be 5, in the 5D series the number of orbit will be 6, in the 6D series the number of orbit will be 7. When we observe here, down the group the number of orbit increases, therefore the atomic size will be increases. When we talk that generally, the atomic size from left to right, the size will be decreases. Down the group the atomic size will be increases. Due to the increase in the number of orbit, this increase in the number, that is nuclear charge. Then, when we take the D block elements, but it is not regular in the D block elements. It is not regular in the D block elements. Then let us see what will happen here. From scandium to chromium, the atomic size will be scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium. From scandium to and chromium, the nuclear charge will be increases, therefore the atomic size will be decreases. The nuclear charge increases, therefore the atomic size will be decreases. And from manganese to, that is manganese, iron, cobalt, copper, nickel, copper, from manganese to and copper, the size of an atomic size will be remained approximately same. The atomic size will be remains approximately same because the nuclear charge will approximately equal to the screening effect. Here the nuclear charge is dominating, and here both are equal, here nuclear charge and screening इंडक्टेंस आर अप्रोक्सिमेटली इक्वल, देयरफॉर फ्रॉम मैंगनीज टू कॉपर द एटॉमिक साइज विल बी रिमेंस अप्रोक्सिमेटली सेम, बट फ्रॉम कॉपर टू जिंक द एटॉमिक साइज विल बी इंक्रीजेस, द एटॉमिक साइज विल बी इंक्रीजेस बिकॉज द स्क्रीनिंग इफेक्ट विल इंक्रीज, एंड द स्क्रीनिंग इफेक्ट इंक्रीजेस ऑटोमेटिकली साइज ऑफ एन एटम विल बी इंक्रीजेस. वंस अगेन आई विल रिपीट द एनाटॉमिक साइज फॉर द डी ब्लॉक इन 3D सीरीज एलिमेंट. फ्रॉम स्कैंडियम टू क्रोमियम द न्यूक्लियर चार्ज इंक्रीजेस, देयरफॉर द साइज विल बी डिक्रीजेस, एंड फ्रॉम मैंगनीज टू कॉपर and nuclear charge will become equal to the screening effect, therefore the atomic size will be approximately equal, and from copper to zinc the screening effect will be increases, therefore the atomic size will be increases. When we compare the s block element or p block element, in the s block element from left to right and size will be decreases and from down the group the atomic size will be increases. This is due to the regular, and when we observe here the last, in the s block element the last electron enter into the last orbit, therefore the regularly from left to right the atomic size will be decreases and down the group the atomic size will be increases. But when we observe the d block element, the last electron enter into the penultimate orbit, therefore it is not regular, that atomic size is not regular in the d block elements. Then when we take the down the group, that is 3d, first 3d, 4d, 5d, regularly from down the group the atomic size will be increases, that is 3d will have less atomic size when, that is 4d will have greater atomic size when compared to the 4d, 4d will have greater atomic size when compared to 3d, and the 5d elements have great bulk. When we compare the 3d, 4d, 5d, 3d, 4d and down the group, that is 3d, 4d, 5d, the atomic size of 4d will be greater than, and atomic size of 4d will be greater than 3d, and the atomic size of and 5d will be greater than 4d. This is regular in the other cases, but in the d block elements it is not regular. The 3d elements, that 4d elements have the greater atomic size compared to the 3d, but when we observe the 5d, the 5d elements will have the and less atomic size compared to the and 4d elements. Regularly down the group the atomic size will be increases, but it is not regular in the 3d, that is 3d series or d block elements. This is due to the, that is when we compare the 4d series, the 4d series have the greater atomic size compared to the 3d, but the 5d series elements will have the lesser atomic size compared to the and 4d series. This is due to lanthanide contraction. Due to the lanthanide contraction, that is contraction decrease in the atomic size in the lanthanide. We will see this lanthanide contraction detail in the and lanthanide series of the F block elements. Due to the lanthanide contraction, the 5D series elements atomic size will be lesser compared to the 4D series elements. This is about the atomic size for the and D block elements. The next topic is, that is second property and oxidation state. Oxidation state, these will show the variable oxidation state. Variable oxidation state. The oxidation state, the D block elements will show the variable oxidation state when we compare the S block element, that is first group elements and second group elements. These will show and fixed oxidation state. These will show the fixed oxidation state because these will contain the fixed number of electrons in the outermost orbit. But 3D series elements or D block elements will not contain fixed number of and electrons in the all electrons in the outermost orbit. The variation of when we observe here in the scandium 21, that is 3D1 4S2, titanium 3D2 4S2, this variable in the oxidation number, that is variable in the electronic configuration, it will varies the oxidation state. Then one of the special and it is important for the examination, one of the special characters for the D block element is the variable in the oxidation state. Let us see cadmium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper and zinc. In the 3D series elements, the manganese will show +1, +2, +3, +4, +5, +6, +7 oxidation states. The manganese will show from +1 to +7 oxidation states. This is the oxidation state of the manganese. Outermost, that is, this oxidation state will depend on the number of electrons present in the outermost orbit. Then, for the chromium, the oxidation state, it may show the oxidation state +2, +3, +4, +5, and +6. That is, chromium will show from +1 to +6 oxidation state. The scandium will show only +3 oxidation state and the zinc will show only +2 oxidation state. The oxidation state of zinc will be fixed, that is +2, and oxidation state of scandium will show the +3. These are fixed. And the oxidation number of copper will be, it may show +1 or it may show +2. It may show the +1 or it may show the +2 oxidation state. Whereas iron may show the +2, +3, +4 and +6. It will show the +2, +3, +4 or and +6 is the oxidation state. For the cobalt, +2, +3, +4 and sometime it will show the +5 oxidation state. Then here the nickel will show +2, +3 and +4 oxidation state. When we take the vanadium, it will show +2, +3, +4 oxidation state. And for the titanium, it may show +1, +2, +3 oxidation state. These variable oxidation state will be shown by the D block element mainly due to the partially filled D orbitals. Okay, the variable oxidation state is mainly due to the partially filled D orbitals. Due to the partially filled D orbitals, the D block elements will show the variable oxidation state. The manganese will show from +1 to +7 oxidation state. The highest state is +7 in the ready series. Sometimes the osmium will show +8 oxidation state. The osmium will show the +8 oxidation state. In the 3D series, the maximum oxidation state will be shown by the manganese. The oxidation state of scandium is only +3. +3 is the oxidation, only it will show +3. And zinc will show only plus 2 oxidation state. This is about the and variable oxidation state for the and 3D series elements. In this class we have discussed the atomic size for the D block elements and variable oxidation state. Variable oxidation state of an D block element are 3D series elements. Regularly, for that is generally from tetrahedral atomic size will be decreases and down the group atomic size will be increases. We will increase in the number of orbits, but it is not regular in the D block elements. From cadmium to chromium, the atomic size will be decreases due to increase in the nuclear charge. From manganese to copper, the atomic size will be remains approximately same because nuclear charge is equal to the screening effect. Here, the nuclear charge is dominant, therefore the atomic size will be decreases. And here, the screening effect will be decreases. Screening effect will be dominant over the nuclear charge, therefore the size will be increases from copper to zinc. Down the group, generally when we take the generally, the atomic size of an 3D series will be less than 4D series. 4D series will be less than the 5D series, but it is not regular in the 3D series. The 4D series will have greater atomic size when compared to the 5D series. This is due to the lanthanide contraction. This lanthanide contraction we will discuss in the detail in the F block element. F block element lanthanide series. In the lanthanide series we will discuss the lanthanide contraction. The variable oxidation state, the maximum oxidation state will be shown by the and manganese, that is plus 1 to plus 7 it will show, and the fixed oxidation state is the common oxidation state is the plus 3. The common oxidation state in the 3D series element is the plus 3. The zinc will show the plus 2 oxidation state. Okay, so this is about the today's class. In the next class we will discuss and ionization enthalpy. We will discuss in the next class ionization enthalpy.